Greetings. Let's spend just a few more minutes and meditate on 1 John chapter 5. Whosoever believeth that Jesus is the Christ is born of God, and everyone that loveth him that begat loveth him also that is begotten of him. So we can see from this, it's talking about the begotten Son of God. By this we know that we love the children of God, when we love God and keep his commandments. For this is the love of God, that we keep his commandments, and his commandments are not grievous. For whatsoever is born of God overcometh the world. And this is the victory that overcomes the world, even our faith. Who is he that overcometh the world, but he that believeth that Jesus is the Son of God? That is worth repeating. Who is he that overcometh the world, but he that believeth that Jesus is the Son of God? He that believeth what? That Jesus is the Son of God. This is he that came by water and blood, even Jesus Christ, not by water only, but by water and blood. And it is the Spirit that beareth witness, because the Spirit is truth. Notice here it's talking about the Holy Spirit, the Spirit that Jesus said he would come, the Spirit of truth. And notice it says, because the Spirit, meaning the Holy Spirit, is truth. For there are three that bear record in heaven, the Father, the Word, and the Holy Ghost. And these three are one. And there are three that bear witness in earth, the Spirit, and the water, and the blood. And these three agree in one. If we receive the witness of men, the witness of God is greater. For this is the witness of God, which he has testified of his Son. This is the witness of God. This is what God says. This is what God has said through his prophets. This is what God said from the clouds, which he has testified of his Son. God has testified of his Son. God, Almighty God, Jehovah, Yahweh, the God who appeared to Moses. This is the witness, the testimony of God, who has testified of his Son. Look at that again. If we receive the witness of men, the witness of God is greater. For this is the witness of God, which has testified of his Son. He that believeth on the Son of God has the witness in himself. He that believeth not God has made him, God, a liar. So if you don't believe God, that Jesus is his Son, you call God a liar. Because he believeth not the record, the testimony, the witness that God gave of his Son. You who call yourself Muslim, you call God a liar. You call Almighty God a liar. Because you say God has no son. Think about it. You want to believe you follow God. You want to think you honor God and submit to God. And by your act of submission to Muhammad and to his words, you call Almighty God a liar. You are calling God a liar. And it's your hope, your heart's desire to be following this very same God that you're calling a liar. Let that sink in. He that believeth on the Son of God has this witness in himself. He that believeth not God has made him a liar, because he believeth not the record that God gave of his Son. When you reject God's witness that Jesus is his Son, you call God a liar. And this is the record that God has given to us, eternal life, and this life is in his Son. He that hath the Son hath life, and he that has not the Son of God has not life. If you do not have the Son of God in your heart, you do not have eternal life. You do not have eternal life if you do not have the Son of God. Oh, but we respect Jesus. No, you don't. If you don't believe he's the Son of God, you are calling God a liar. These things have I written unto you that believe on the name of the Son of God, that you may know that you have eternal life, and that you may believe on the name of the Son of God. And this is the confidence that we have in him, that if we ask anything according to his will, he heareth us. And if we know that he hears us, whatsoever we ask, we know that we have the petitions that we desire of him. If any man see his brother sin a sin which is not unto death, he shall ask, and he shall give him life for them that sin not unto death. There is a sin unto death. I do not say that he shall pray for it. All unrighteousness is sin, and there is a sin not unto death. We know that whosoever is born of God sinneth not. But he that is begotten of God keepeth himself, and that wicked one touches him not. And we know that we are of God, and the whole world lieth in wickedness. And we know that the Son of God is come, and has given us an understanding, that we may know him that is true. And we are in him that is true, even in his Son, Jesus Christ. This is the true God and eternal life. And we know that the Son of God has come. And we know that the Son of God has come. And we know. We know. We know. This is our confidence. We know with absolute certainty that the Son of God has come. The Son of God. The Son of God. Glory to the Son of God. Glory to his name forevermore. The Son of God has come. Little children, keep yourselves from idols. Amen. Here's the command of God to keep yourselves from idols and to honor and obey the Son of God. Clearly, in God's mind, worshiping the Son of God is not making an idol, because the Son of God is God and is worthy of worship and praise and honor and glory forever and ever. Amen. Allow the Word of God to renew your mind and bring you strength, and to clarify the confusion brought by those, especially in Islam, who wish to seduce you to another gospel, which is no gospel at all. Do not allow the deceptions of Mohammedism, of Islam, to say there is no Son of God. Don't allow that, because the Word of God tells you what to think of the man who says Jesus is not the Son of God. He is a liar, and he calls God a liar because he does not listen to God's testimony. Who are you going to believe, God or someone who calls God a liar? May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, who God himself testified was his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.